So for a while, flashlight manufacturers have ignored people who like strobe modes. Okay, just kidding. Nearly every flashlight has a strobe mode. They can be used from everything to dance parties to, I don't know, tactical things to SOS. I think I read that wrong. Sunwayman continues the grand tradition of offering strobe modes on flashlights, but giving the strobe mode its own button with the new G25C. So you're probably like, strobes are useful and all, and it's normally all I use when walking around at night because of its calming effect. But what about those odd times when I just need regular light? Well, Sunwayman hasn't forgotten about the minority of people who use flashlights for just solid constant output. They designed a two-button compact flashlight with three regular modes. Like most flashlights, now this one is covered in a Type 3 anodization, has a smooth reflector, a coated tempered glass lens, and uses a cool white XML2 emitter. It runs off a 18650 battery or two CR123A size batteries if you like throwing batteries away. It has four main modes. I have included Sunwayman's claims and my estimated levels for each mode. My rating should be taken with a grain of salt because it's a DIY lumen measuring device. First is low, which is a manufacturer rated 16 lumens for 80 hours. Mid, which is a 150 lumen output for 6 hours. And high, which starts at 1,000 lumens and then steps down to 400 lumens after 3 minutes. Although I did not find that to be the case. Oh, and that fourth mode is strobe. So let's test some of those runtimes. Again, I said high did not behave like Sunwayman says it does. It starts out bright and slowly creeps down before dimming dramatically and ending at about 1 hour and 14 minutes. It kind of gradually dimmed the whole time. Mid runs constantly for about 3 hours and 15 minutes. I used a Sanyo UR18650F 26 milliamp hour battery for the tests. Sunwayman gave the G25C three operating modes just because they could: tactical, outdoor, and daily. All modes are operated off of two buttons. One is big and raised, and the other is flush and small. So it's super easy to tell the difference in the dark, provided you have a sense of touch. The main thing to remember is that the big button is the power button, and the small button changes modes and activates strobe. Strobe. The little button from off is always momentary strobe. When the light is on, the little button cycles modes, or you can hold it to activate constant strobe, I guess so you don't have to keep your finger on it. To change these groups, you'll need to hold both buttons down and loosen the head and tighten it quickly. It's as awkward as it sounds. It'll give you one blink for tactical, two for outdoor, and three for daily. Group one is tactical, has only two modes, strobe and high, with no mode memory. Group two is outdoor, has three modes, strobe, of course, low and high, with no mode memory. It always turns on in high. And finally, group three, daily group, the one I like and the one the G25C is set to from the factory. The little button from off gives you momentary strobe. The big button turns it on and off. A tap of the little button cycles between low, mid, and high, then low, mid, high, etc. A long press of the little button, strobe stays on, just like I said earlier. Strobe. Nice. A quick press of the little button gets you back to whatever mode you were on before you went full strobe. And everyday mode has mode memory, so when you turn it on and off, it remembers the last mode you were on. And while it technically isn't momentary, it can be turned on and off very quickly without changing modes just by pressing the big button. I feel like one operating group would have been sufficient. Sorry, no, it was boring. I probably should have added a cat meme or, I don't know, a Donald Trump reference, because I guess the internet likes those things right now. Okay, so how about a beam shot comparison, otherwise known as flashlight porn? The Sunwayman is a small light and the reflector is a bit smaller in diameter, so it isn't considered a thrower. But here's a few other lights in the same size category that show you the difference. And on each light, you'll see my estimated maximum output claims, so you have a relative number at least to go with the picture. First, we'll do a test on the creepy shed at 75 feet, then some trees at a distance of about 250 feet. My measurements here are done with the cheap lux meter and are modeled after the FL1 standard. The figures I'm estimating are the candela, lumen output on the highest mode of each light, and the throw distance in meters. The FL1 standard I found is pretty generous on how far the beam is ready to go, but I'm doing it just like the manufacturers do. Well, sorta. By the way, all my lumens figures are calibrated using a Phoenix light. My numbers should be used as an estimate only, but the figures do provide an insight into how each light performs in relation to one another. By the way, you'll notice the G25C does the worst in a basic throw test, which is because it has the smallest reflector. Hey, wake up! Alright, so how about a few other things? The light is tiny, and it comes with a clip, a spare O-ring, and a lanyard. Surprise! It's easy to operate, which is a plus. It tail stands even with the switches on the tail cap because of a few bevels. Make sure it's on a flat surface, though, because it's not super duper stable. It has a bit of uninteresting knurling on the center, so it gives you some added grip. Cool, now I can check off the talk about knurling box on my flashlight review chart. It isn't a whole lot bigger in diameter than my EDC Convoy S5, and it's actually shorter because there's a small reflector and the electronic switches save a little bit of length. Since it is an electronic switch, loosen the tail cap when not in use to prevent accidental activation. Okay, what about one or two final opinions before I cut this shit short? Things I don't like. I wish it came in a neutral white or warm white option. I wish all flashlights did. Also, there's no moonlight mode. Armytek is awesome because they usually feature these as options or features on most lights they release. Listen up, Sunwayman. Alright, so how about things I like? Well, it's EDC size for larger pockets, and it's simple to operate. It seemed cool, even though it wasn't, you know, that interesting. I guess it could have acted like a dick, but it didn't. Alright, so thanks for watching, and subscribe to my channel if you like reviews and videos about EDC gear like knives, flashlights, headlamps, all with bizarre jokes. Even if you don't like any of those things, subscribe anyway, because I have a really good personality.